Hi, welcome back to another video of this robot framework tutorial. It's finally time to get started with installing robot framework on Windows. So for that, the first step is to install Python. As I was saying, robot framework is Python dependent at its core. So on any operating system that supports Python, robot framework should run just fine. For that, I will open up a new browser and I will type Python. And normally, I should see the first link to python.org. I will click downloads and I will choose download Python 3.8.3. Because robot framework is something that is very updated and there's a large community of people who are working around the clock to keep it at its best shape, you can be sure that robot framework will always be compatible with the latest versions of Python. In this first window, so I will choose to add Python 3.8 to path, and I will explain later what to do if you don't click this. And I get to choose from two installation options. The first one is to install the default packages and to install them at this location. And the second one is to customize the installation. For me personally, I prefer to customize my installation in order to be able to choose a custom directory for the Python installation. The reason is very simple. I will use later that particular folder to store different files needed for my automation process, such as command libraries or web drivers for different browsers. So I will choose customize. I will leave this page as it is, and I will make sure that pip is checked because this is the package manager that we will later use to install robot framework. Okay, click next. You don't have to change anything in here, but here is where I was saying I'm going to change the installation path. So in my case, I will install it directly under C, Python 3.8. I will click install and I will wait for the process to finish. It shouldn't take long because Python installs rapidly on a Windows machine. And it will also install all the prerequisites and the packages I've chosen at the installation screen. Setup was successful and now I can click the close button. In order to verify that Python was correctly installed into my system, I can open up a terminal and say Python --- version. And as you can see, the correct version is displayed. Please take note that if this does not happen for you, so if you get the error that Python is not recognized as an internal or external command by any chance, this is related to the fact that the Python executable was not put into path. This is exactly what I was telling you about when I launched the installer. So by clicking add Python executable to path, what happened was that here under environment variables, under path, I now have two new paths for Python. So it's the installation directory and a scripts directory where all the scripts will be installed. Okay, Python is correctly installed. Now it's time to install robot framework. In order to install robot framework, we must use the pip package manager. In order to see if pip was correctly installed, we can run a pip list. And normally we should be able to see that we have the pip version 19 and the setup tools 41.2.0. these versions are not important at the moment, but what is important is that the pip command was recognized, so that means that we can go ahead and install robot framework. One more thing about installing robot framework. So if we go on Google and we say robot framework releases, we can check the actual version that is currently in production. So in our case, the version is 3.2.1. As a side note, version 3.2 of robot framework was the version where support was dropped for Python 2.x, and there were a lot of other changes that were made. So if you are using Python 2.x in your code and you still want to automate, it's best to try with robot framework 3.1.2. Let's install now robot framework, and I will show you exactly how to install a certain version that you want. So we stated that the latest version is 3.2.1, but let's say, for example, I want to install robot framework 3.1.2. I will say pip install robot framework equal equal 3.1.2. And now if I go ahead and type pip list, I can see that robot framework 3.1.2 was installed. If I want to upgrade to the latest version, in our case 3.2.1, all I have to do is say pip install minus minus upgrade robot framework. And this will uninstall the 3.1.2 and install the 3.2.1. So again, pip list. And I can see that the robot framework is correctly installed. To double check if robot framework works, I can go ahead and type robot into the same terminal. So that is the command we are using to launch robot scripts or automated robots tests. And if all goes according to plan, yep, we should get something like this. So it's an error stating that the robot command needs at least one argument, but it got zero. We will see later on what this error means. But the most important thing is that I did not get an error saying that a robot was not recognized as an internal or external command. Robot framework is correctly installed. So now all I need is to start writing my first automated scripts. For that, I'm going to need an IDE, and that is exactly what we are going to install in the next video. If you found this video interesting, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button so you are notified each time I upload a new video. See you later.